Hello everyone, this is a video I've been wanting to make for quite some time because it's a video, or it's more so information that I stumbled upon myself and couldn't find anywhere else. So, anyway, this is a video about XXXTentacion and his ties to the occult through Bruno Dickams, who he lived with from the time I believe he was 17 to 18 years old. So, what got me started on this video is a former associate of XXX458Keys was asked about a porn shoot, and I believe that he kind of hinted at Bruno being a cult or a cult leader.
As? Did you ever see the X porno?
Jesus Christ. I'm not talking on that.
You got one in the stash?
How do you know about that?
I'm just going to assume. You spent that much time at Bruno's house. I used to live there. Yeah, you gotta live.
What are you saying, bro? I got my groupie lust too. Don't get it twisted.
First dude got groupie lust.
I got my groupie lust too on me. Yeah.
Do you think that the ex sex tape will ever leak?
No.
Nah, they don't got enough money for that.
No.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
Money for that. If that shit is there, shit. You
I don't know what you
that.
Guys are talking about ex sex tape, but I'm just saying whatever went on, it just never happened. Sorry. I don't know.
Bruno's. If you went there,
if you know what Bruno
you know
is,
we can't talk about this. Yeah.
Took me straight to Google who Bruno was, and all I could find was Reddit posts by a former manager named Tables. Now, if you notice, they're saying he performs dark rituals at Bruno's house. Wow, that's insane! Dark rituals at Bruno's house. So after seeing this, I looked up bunch of random stuff about Bruno, and this is how he views himself.
Smart question, because most people don't even ask, they assume. Is it metaphorical? You know what? You're the first one to hit it on the dot. Thank you. That right there is a metaphor for myself. That's me. I am the fucking Baphomet.
After seeing that clip, it kind of gave me the information I wanted and set out to find out that is if Bruno was a cult leader or part of a cult. And he clearly is if he is worshipping Baphomet, which was worshipped by the Knights Templar and other religions, the Gnostics, as mentioned earlier. Now he's mentioning in his lyrics about the Baphomet. They obviously took the stuff very seriously, and it makes you think about the young woman who died near XXXTentacion before he got famous or before his 17 album, Jocelyn Flores. If they're into dark rituals, what really happened to Jocelyn Flores, right? Anyway, thank you for your time, and thanks for watching this video. Found some connections to XXXTentacion and Thelema or Aleister Crowley's religion. I will start it off with this clip here to show why I made this video.
If you're going to listen to an artist consistently and it's your favorite artist, you most definitely should understand who it is that you're looking into or listening to. But in my situation, they definitely should pay attention to what I am as a person rather than a character. But it is hard to mend these two things together if everything that I portray as an artist is purely art. So it's hard to tell if as a person that anything that is controversial or spoken on about me is remotely even true. There's brainwashing that gets involved in music and the music industry, like recording things backwards and all these different things that people don't know, frequency channelings and different things like that. So you never know who you're fucking with unless you fully dwell into them as a person.
So keeping that in mind, I did some research. I looked up some things about XXXTentacion, and it led me to Teflon Sean and his manager Bruno, but I will show more from Teflon Sean. So there's the golden beetle that XXX was talking about lots. He used to say, study the golden beetle. Always said he couldn't say too much, but it was because he was sworn to secrecy. He could not say anything about it other than the clues. So this is the wall that divided the rooms, apparently. The pale horse, that is the fourth rider in the apocalypse, I believe that is the horse that he rides in on. And the next clip one is going to be, so this is a painting of a demon, it seems. Tankid 666, it seems to be modeled after, which is one of X's old friends. And so after seeing his Instagram, I was like, oh, that's really scary. I should probably go look at his Twitter to see if I can find anything there. So I went to his Twitter, and there was a demon sitting on an all-seeing eye, and he was calling it Father. And I was like, okay, that is not good from the outside perspective. Just the beginning of the end, World Domination 666. Who is this guy? Like, who is Teflon Sean? Why is he saying this stuff? How does he have connections to the end of the world? This seems to be 666 Sacred Geometry, so that's a pyramid. If anybody has answers for me about that, put in the comments, please. Our mission is still the same, destroy Earth through control of children's minds. And so this guy has connections to Bruno Dickums and the porn industry, so that's really interesting that you'd say that. World Domination, Chapter 3, Verse 6, that is when the Antichrist took over in the Bible. So Aleister Crowley is the only human he looks up to. Aleister Crowley was a murderer and a child molester. He did many magical rituals which involved murder and blood rituals. So this is where Aleister Crowley is said to have got most of his knowledge through channeling. I'm not sure what the tablet actually means. I'll have to do more research. All 72 demons of the lesser key, one by one, till your energy never existed. So that's the lesser key of Solomon. That's a spell book. You can summon demons with that. Happiness lies within oneself, and the only way to dig it out is cocaine. Dude is a cokehead. That's crazy. I thought this was interesting because that's Elon Musk's child's name, I think. So that's a wild tweet predicting the name of Elon Musk's kid. Do what thou wilt, so be the whole of the law. Crowley and Thelema. Gotta love them. And that's some Freemasonry stuff, I guess. You have to be a member to really go into the lodges, I think, because of their connections to the occult. That this is just more alarming. Freemasonry at the highest levels is Lucifer worship. And here's XXXTentacion quoting Crowley.
Okay, so my current focus is creation and evolution. No matter whether you realize it or not, every day you evolve. Every day you create. You create in thought, you evolute in mind, you evolute as far as your age, you evolute physically, mentally. If you are evoluting physically and you are not evoluting mentally, you are not doing the right thing.
I thought this was pretty much what X was saying in that. So he's using Aleister Crowley's teachings to promote his beliefs to a new generation.
Listen, I want to say something to you guys. Alright, so listen. No matter what anybody tells you, each and every individual in here is a star. All of you are here.
It is just absolutely crazy to me to think that XXXTentacion could have been a recruiting tool for Thelema. Or their cult, you know what I mean? Their ideals. Because that is pretty much what he's saying. That is, he's quoting him pretty much directly. And he was into some dark stuff. Thelema is no joke, and you don't want to be messing with these demons out here, really. I understand this stuff is real to them, and it can be, it seems real. So I'll show a direct quote of his. Human sacrifice is the best. All right, I'm gonna leave it at that. Thanks for watching. 5 1. I just wanted to make this video with a narration because I wanted to give my opinion on why I made this video and why it seemed plausible to me that he could have set up his own killing. So, XXXTentacion, he was into the occult. We know that he knew a lot about the energies of the universe and how they worked. He knew that if you wanted the world, you would have to give something. So he, in my opinion, I think he may have agreed to give himself in order to get what he wanted from this world. Alright, so coming up with this first clip, it's going to be Bruno Dickums, who was his former manager, writing a post about how Angelina Jolie wanted to kill herself, but she couldn't do it because she didn't want her family to live with the guilt, so she wanted to get herself assassinated. He said, "Sounds familiar. Figure that one out." So, coming up next, I would suggest pausing this because it just goes off some over some reasons as to why maybe he set himself up. There's one more here. Now, I found this absolutely amazing when I was researching this stuff. I didn't realize that all those connections could be actually a thing. So, as I explained that, I explained it earlier in the audio. Yes, he said he would not sacrifice anyone, but he would sacrifice himself. So this gives me more evidence that maybe he sacrificed himself.
We can sacrifice them. Yeah, we can. I don't want to, though. I don't do sacrifices. I just do hard work. And if I'm going to sacrifice anything, it's going to be myself. Selfish. I just want you out of my old.
That he could have sacrificed himself. And here's another clip of him saying he'd be dead before a certain time frame.
And he was fucking around with the chopsticks. And we were just sitting there. And we started talking about kids.
He was like, "You're gonna be a great dad. So you're gonna be a great dad too someday, bro." He said, "No, I'm not." So, what do you mean? And he just looked me dead in the eye and he was like, "I'm not gonna make it past 21. And then just went right back to fucking with the chopsticks. Like he hadn't said a day. And he was fucking around with the chopsticks. And we were just sitting there. And we started talking about kids. And he was like, "You're gonna be a great dad. So you're gonna be a great dad too someday, bro." And he said, "No, I'm not." So what do you mean? And he just looked me dead in the eye and he's like, "I'm not gonna make it past 21. And it just went right back to fucking with the chopsticks. Like he hadn't said a thing. Have you dreamed
about that?" Now this is going more into what I was saying earlier. XXXTentacion understood the occult. He knew that he would have to give energy in order to equalize the universe. "I will kill myself. It would benefit all my friends. I'm sorry, Mama. I did not mean to hurt you." Right? Like, his mother is now rich because of a sacrifice. His friends got popular because of a sacrifice. I know they're not so popular now, but during that time they were. Anyway, yeah, Members Only is his rap group. That was his friends. They maybe not would have not had longevity from their success. I don't really see much of them now. But, and he was also facing 20 years in jail, and to him, it was a living hell. He did not like jail. He hated jail, right?
So. Supposed to sensationalize and idolize this jail shit, bro. That shit not cool, bro. That shit is not cool, bro. That shit is hell, bro. That is hell. That is hell on earth. That is hell on earth. That is literally hell on earth. I have never actually, bro, like, there was times where I wanted to die when I was young, but I was most content with death when I was there. If I had an opportunity, I probably would have. You know what I'm saying? That shit is hell to me. So, if they let a young man be a young man, and they let me move on with my life, and let me be the person I need to be, not only for myself, but for the kids, because, bro, if they fuck me over, bro, they fucking up the kids, bro. And it's sad, but it's the truth. Bro, people feel like they got so much control over their kids, but no, fam, the internet really do. And I'm a fucking internet sensation. It was behind some negative shit, but I turned it into a positive.
So now, yeah, I think that because of the demon he was in touch with, you know, maybe they told him to kill himself or he would be back in jail, right? And so his date that he died ends up evening out to 666. 666, I think, and two more sixes after that. All sixes, which are numbers for sacrifice. We know that 666 is associated with evil. It is just probably the most famous one out there. And here comes some lyrics pointing towards his death.
time to sleep. Pray the Lord my soul to keep. Hope's not too late for me. Whoa.
Now we know XXXTentacion, he was a very smart guy. He would not write music in a way that seemed wrong. Like, before I lay me down to sleep, that does not sound right. Thank you for listening, and just please follow if you would like to hear more content from me.